made significant progress in every field imaginable.
Tom, the entire world has benefited from your work in ways you can't imagine.
That's right, Tom. You're an inspiration to all inventors.
Of course I am.
But time marches on, Tom. In just 30 years, my computer now looks like a primitive tool. But it inspired many other inventors, artists, and programmers.
They stole your idea?
No, not at all. My invention, like all yours, was protected by a United States patent. They improved on my idea and used it for things even I couldn't have thought of.
And that same sort of evolution happens to health technologies as well.
Are people living longer now, Helen?
Not just longer, Mr. President, but living better.
I just can't imagine the progress that's been made in 200 years.
Well, the fact is that one new idea leads to another, and then to a third, and so on through a course of time, until someone with whom none of these ideas was original combines them all together and produces what is justly called a new invention.
We expect more than 400,000 patent applications on new ideas just this year alone. Many that will change the world, and they come from all kinds of inventors, some inventing in megacorporations, or universities, or basements.
I started in my garage.
Or basements and garages.
From what these fine people have told us, President Madison, your notion of giving Congress the power to promote science by granting patent protection has served the nation well.
Thank you for the kind words, Mr. Jefferson. However, it is obviously the ingenuity of the American people that really has made it.
They go hand in hand, James. Hand in hand.
My friends, I hope you've enjoyed this portrait of the United States Patent and Trademark Office. Enjoy the rest of your visit here at the National Inventors Hall of Fame and Museum. Portraits, let's take a break.
Before you go, perhaps you'd like to hear more about my 1,093 amazing inventions.
Tom!
Oh, all right.
Please enter the